Good evening. This podcast is recorded on 22nd September 2017. This is Kritika, an associate working with Center for Law and Policy Research, Bangalore. In 2017, CLPR set up Supreme Court Observer to track high impactful cases. SEO is a non-partisan effort to make the work of Supreme Court intelligible and easily accessible to anyone interested in Indian public affairs. The web link to our site is seobserver@clpr.org.in, spelled as scobserver@clpr.org.in. Today, we have Satya, who's tracking the Tehseen Poonawalla versus Union of India case, which relates to the menace of cow vigilantism and state's responsibility to curb the same. We have introduction and background to post to this case, which is posted in SC Observer website. This podcast will track today's proceedings of the case. So Satya, what was today's hearing all about?
Kritika, today Indira Jaising, representing Tushar Gandhi, one of the petitioners, brought it to the notice of the court that despite the court asking all states to file compliance report, only 5 states have done so. With only 5 states submitting compliance report, the Chief Justice asked all states to file their report before 13th October. Indira Jaising also raised the issue of abysmal state of victim compensation schemes by referring to the unfortunate state of Junaid's family. Junaid, a 16-year-old boy, was killed by a mob in a train compartment simply on suspicion of being a beef eater. Indira Jaising brought to the court's notice that Junaid's father is yet to receive any state support despite there being a statutory victim compensation scheme. The bench responded that all states are obligated to compensate victims of cow vigilantism. Indira Jaising also informed the bench that she has prepared a memo scope of cooperative federalism and centrist power to direct states under Article 256, and she wanted to place it before the bench. This was in response to centrist plea in previous hearing that since law and order is a state subject, so center does not have the power under the constitution to direct state on law and order issue.
So Satya, were there any other arguments that were made today?
Yes, Kritika. Today, at the end of the day's proceeding, Kapil, Sibal, representing Tehseen Poonawalla, requested the bench to broaden the ambit of compliance report by also including investigation report in cow vigilante cases. He told the court that while the perpetrators of violence in the name of protecting cows were out on bail, the victims faced FIRs and persecution. However, the bench declined this request to broaden the scope of compliance report at this stage and posted the matter for 31st October of this year.
Thanks, Satya. We will follow the podcast with a detailed summary of proceedings at SEO website. Thank you all for listening. Follow us on Facebook at Supreme Court Observer and Twitter at SC Observer for more updates.